Climate change is not a future reality threat, it is a present reality, says Ban Ki-moon, chairman of the United Nations. A very good morning to everyone present here. Myself, Pallav Shalke from Standard 9B, BHS Alkapuri, am here to present my thoughts on the topic, climate change is an international problem. I am not responsible, what can I do? Climate change is the current rapid increase of the Earth's climate. This is caused by various greenhouse gases, methane, carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbons, etc. The rising temperature of the earth can cause several long-term changes. Already, there has been bleaching of coral reefs, melting of polar ice caps, increase in number of natural disasters, and mass extinction of species. As per latest reports, climate change over the next century might turn out to be much more worse than expected. There could be a 6 degrees increase in average monthly summer temperatures, an increase of nearly 4 meters of sea level, and increased occurrences of drought. Climate change is largely linked with human activities like mining, use of fossil fuels, industrialization and deforestation. So if so many factors cause climate change, can it be reversed? If yes, which solution should be implemented? CO2 is climate's worst enemy and is released when fossil fuels and coal are burned for energy which we use to power our homes, cars, smartphones, etc. By using less of it, we can reduce global warming and also save money. Using energy-efficient devices is also equally important, like replacing incandescent bulbs with compact fluorescent lamps, CFL. CFL uses 4 times less energy and serves 8 times longer life than the normal incandescent bulbs. CFLs should be made mandatory and each in every home. Similarly, the use of laptops like desktop computers uses 5 times less energy. We should use bicycles, public transport or walk as much as possible. By this, we can control carbon dioxide emissions and also keep ourselves fit. By keeping our tires properly inflated, we can improve fuel efficiency by reducing 5% of the amount of fuel used. A single tree absorbs 1 ton of carbon dioxide, plus produces oxygen during its entire lifetime. If we plant even 1 tree and ensure its growth, we will definitely help in contributing our small effort towards a green climate. Judicious use of water can be practiced even in day-to-day life, like using a mug of water for brushing, washing hands, using a bucket rather than a shower, etc. Rainwater harvesting should also be promoted. Renewable energies like solar, wind, geothermal and biomass should be used as an alternative for fossil fuels. And last but not least, we should implement the concept of reduce, reuse and recycle. Using a cloth bag rather than a plastic one, using recycled plastic bottles and using recycled paper are just a few examples of this. In short, our individual participation for a better tomorrow is just as crucial as governmental rule. At the end, it is in our hands. As being the future leaders of tomorrow, we have the passion, commitment and energy to make a difference. Thank you.